Hello you, it's day 6 of the ISSF Junior World Cup Sydney 2018. I'm Jamie Stangroom and this is the 10 metre air pistol mixed team junior event. A moment in history, you could say. It's the first time that this has been an official event at a Junior World Cup. I've got a guest with me. It is a pistol shooter from India. His name is Japjesh Singh Jaspal. How are you, Japjesh?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing very good. All the better to have you as my guest because I saw you yesterday up on the podium down there accepting a team medal. How did that feel?
It was a great moment for me. I couldn't come in the finals, but yeah, it was difficult. Yeah, and all the, you know, the match went very well.
Yeah, well, it certainly did, taking that medal. I mean, it's gone very well for India in general, hasn't it, this competition so far, which we'll talk more about in a moment. But Danny Potts, our announcer here at the Sydney Shooting Centre, is about to introduce the teams to the audience here and to you at home. So let's hand over to Danny.
Representing Australia Team 2, Hans Hummer and Sasha Krupin. On 5 points, C1 and C2, representing India Team 1, and they qualified with a Team Junior World Record. D1 and D2 representing the People's Republic of China Team 2, Wang Jihao and Xiao Jiawisha. And finally on 5 points, E1 and E2 representing India Team 2, Gaurav Rana and Mahima Churi Agarwal.
So there's our teams for this final, and the officials are now being introduced to the audience. If this is the first time that you've witnessed one of these finals, and let me explain how it's gonna work, which, you know, we're all learning on the go, aren't we, Japtes, because it is so new. Yeah. But this is the plan anyway. We'll have three series of 5 shots, and for both team members that actually means 10 shots per team. So 5 individual shots, 10 per team. Of course, the scores will be combined. So that's 30 shots per team in total. And that will be in a time of 300 seconds per team per series. And during each series, the two team members must alternate firing shots, with the athlete on the left shooting first and the athlete on the right shooting second. If you shoot out of order, then there will be a penalty, a point deduction. I call that bang out of order. Yeah. Thank you. This will be followed by 9 single shots for both team members, which will be fired on a command in a time of 60 seconds per team per shot. And again, the same left, right order must be followed. Eliminations will begin for the lowest ranking team after shot 17. So that's after the first 2 single shots. I'm talking individual shots there. That's 4 per team. And it will continue after every 2 or 4, whichever way you want to follow it, until the bronze medal has been decided after shot 21 and silver and gold medals after shot 24. So, Japtish, does that sound about right to you?
Yeah.
How have you, I mean, I know this is the first time it's been done at a Junior World Cup, but how have you sort of, how have your teammates been finding it? How have you been finding it so far?
It's great. It's great for India that India shot a world record for the first time. You know, it's the first official event of mixed event. And over that, India won the, got the world record, you know.
It's a big moment, isn't it? Yeah. So that's India Team 1, because of course there are 2 Indian teams in this final. So Anmol and Barker. Barker's had a very good competition.
Yeah.
They shot the junior world record in qualifying to make it into this final.
Yeah, even in the earlier World Cup in Guadalajara, she won 2 golds. You
she
know?
Did. I was there. I announced those. Yeah, she's... I'm sure all of you guys have got... And every athlete here has got a big future in the sport. But at the moment, you know, the sun is shining on India, isn't it?
Yeah, but... I think amongst these all, Manu Bhakra has the most experience as she has already played one in the World Cup earlier this year, and she has won gold in it, right?
That's right, in Guadalajara. So is that useful for yourself and your teammates who haven't been to a senior World Cup yet? Is it useful to have Manu's experience around you?
Yeah, like she also teaches us that don't have a pressure, like make a concentration proper and shoot well. And she's always helpful in everything, you know, like a perfect teammate is.
Yeah, well, she's having a great season so far, and it's only what, two competitions old, really, with Guadalajara and now some Sydney Junior World Cup. And this is your first international competition, isn't it?
Yes.
So how have you found the experience?
It is great for me that I won in the bronze in the first World Cup myself, you know. It is great for me. It was my dream to get a medal in the World Cup. Next step will be to win an individual medal, and then it will be go on like that. Like stairs, you know?
Of course, but every medal counts, you know, so to be on that podium, as you said, it was a big moment. So that was the team medal yesterday for the rapid fire pistol. And I saw you on the podium with your teammates, all looking very proud and rightfully so. But I do have to apologize to you, Jeptesh, because my colleague, Danny Potts, who was announcing the victory ceremony, we would say in the UK, he butchered your name, didn't he? So I can only apologize on his behalf.
Yeah.
For destroying your moment.
No, it's okay.
You forgive him.
Yeah.
Excellent. Just in case he listens back to this on YouTube, how would you teach him to say your name again, the correct pronunciation?
It will be Jeptesh.
Jeptesh.
Yeah.
So really, I've been saying it wrong as well, haven't I?
No, it's all right.
Well, we were talking about Barker.
Yeah.
She's just been on screen. It was 10.9.
Yeah.
So continuing that fine form.
Okay.
We also had a 10.8 for Hummer of Australia as well. This is the first of three series of five shots. And again, because I get confused, when I say five shots, that's per athlete, so 10 per team.
Yeah. That's Gaurav Rana, who got gold silver in the Air Pistol Junior Men event.
Yeah.
Earlier. It's this World Cup.
It's been a great, we said a great year for Manu Barker, but it's been a great year, and the year is young in terms of the shooting season. It's just been a great year for India so far, hasn't
it? Yes.
I think you won them, you were leading the medals table in Guadalajara. The Team India were.
Yes,
and,
yes. That's
I'm
great.
I'm pretty sure you're up there with China at the moment here in Sydney.
That's great, yeah.
And what do you put that down to? The rise of
India shooting?
Indian shooting, yeah, in the last few years.
Yeah, in this event also, India is one goal behind the China. China is on the first medal tally, and India is second. That's even great for India. You know, India is rising, and the shooters are also gaining more experience in going the competitions. You know, like they are gaining more and more experience. Like you can say Manu, Anmol, Gaurav or Mahima, they all are, you know, experienced and great shooters. Yeah.
You know, it's you know, coming to these competitions is one thing, but being in the finals and taking the medals away is another, you know. So and you're a big team, we can see.
Yeah.
Some familiar faces, I'm sure, to you there.
Yes.
Big team. And one thing I've noticed as well, you seem like a happy team. You're always supporting your teammates at each final.
Yes, they're always there, yeah.
Which is great to see. So we've got a table after our first series. It is India Team 1 leading the way, but look at that. Just small differences between the five teams in this table, as you'd expect. It's early days. We've got another two series of five shots coming up, but it is India Team 1 with Anmol and Barker leading the way as things stand over China Team 2, consisting of Wang Jihao and Chao Shou Jiawisha. So we go again. There's Manu. Looking very focused.
Yeah, that concentration.
Which is key in this sport, isn't it? It's concentration.
Yes.
And how do you find, I mean, we just talked about your teammates supporting the athletes down there. How do you find, you know, I don't know what it's like in the domestic competitions you've been competing at, but when you're here and you have the audience cheering, you have the music playing, you have the announcer reminding you of how well you're doing or how bad you're doing.
Yeah.
How do you concentrate in those moments?
Yeah, all of us are supporting to each other, and moreover, like I the coach of our team he's great, really great, and I heard in Sydney that someone was saying that India is always doing something something different. You know, like we are, we get up at five and we do physical exercises.
Really? Five in the morning?
Yeah.
Every morning?
In the hotel, yes.
Wow. As a team? You do this as a team?
Yes, yes. We go for yoga and all, you know. Everybody sees the Indian shooting team, and you know, when they talk and smile to see the Indian shooting very well, that's a great moment for us, and we feel proud that yes, we are grateful to our coaches, Indian coaches.
Wow, so even though you know you are here representing India, but equally you're representing yourself, particularly in the individual events, but it's very much teamwork at the same time. You know, you're getting up at 5 in the morning together, doing your yoga.
Yes.
Do you eat together?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
10.9 there. Was that for Hummer of Australia? You'll know when there's a big hit for either India or Australia. Going by the crowd reaction.
Yeah.
See Australia team 2. And how have you found Australia, you know, generally so far? I mean, and the shooting range, which of course was used for the Sydney 2000 Olympics.
Yeah. As a first World Cup, it's also great, and you know, I have compared to all other ranges, Sydney has a better range and a great, you know, exposure to shooters.
Well, mate, you're at an Olympic shooting range here competing.
Yes, yes.
Surely doesn't get too much better than that.
Yeah.
And I guess, you're obviously very young, 18 years old, making me feel very, very old right now. I feel like a grandpa sat here with you, Mr. Jaspal. I suppose the dream is Tokyo.
Yes, for sure. Slowly by slowly, I told you earlier, steps, you know, the stairs.
Baby steps.
Yes. Yeah. Slowly and slowly.
But it's just around the corner, isn't it? It's creeping up on us. So we are in the second series. We have a live table in front of us. India team 1. In fact, it's not been updated. It looks like China team 1 are actually in the lead. But of course, it's irrelevant because athletes are shooting before others.
India 2 with the 9.7.
That's right, which is a 10 for China. So it does look like a battle between India and China at the moment, which has been the story of this competition, hasn't
yes,
it?
Yes,
really?
Right. In the earlier rapid fire also, India versus China. Yeah.
It was, wasn't it? Three athletes for India, three athletes for China. I think I joked in one of the events earlier in the week when I was doing the announcing, not the commentary, I joked, there's a 10.7 for Amol there, I joked that we're going to rename this event to, you know, from the 10 meter whatever to India versus China.
Yeah, I heard that, yeah.
It's funny, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. That's the right answer. So the second series.
Great shooting by the local boy.
Yeah. The locals really want, you know, to see a medal going to their nation, as you'd expect. There could be a chance here. It's a very competitive final.
Yeah. Great shooting by India 1 also, all 10s.
Very consistent, isn't it, for India Team 1?
Yeah.
10.1, 10.7, 10.10. Also the last score for India 2 was a 10.7.
So has China 1 and China 2.
Yep, so Australia are going to have... They're chasing the pack.
Yeah.
9.2 there.
That's
Hummer.
Is.
Stop. Okay, so that was the Australian teammates looking a little bit tense, watching their teammates out there, currently in fifth position, but they're not out of it yet. But it is India Team 1 still leading the way of Anmol and Barker, 199.1. So they have got a bit of a lead over China Team 1. Breathing down their necks is China Team 2, and they're actually tied with 193.9 with India Team 2. So Australia with a little bit of work to do for Hummer and Crouppen, but we do have one more series of five shots before we enter single shot phase. That seems to be a talking to for Hummer down there. What do you think this could be about?
Maybe...
Oh, he's been shown a card.
Yeah, he's shown a card. Maybe he shot it dry. The trigger?
Yes.
He showed a trigger finger.
Right, okay, so it's difficult for us to exactly work out what's going on, but keeping an eye on their score, 189.8. Will there be a deduction of the score?
For the next competition series.
Doesn't look like it, so was it a warning?
Yeah, it was a warning.
There's Manu back again, still looking focused. As you'd expect. So we talked about your schedule, you know, yoga-ing at 5 a.m. and obviously coming into the range to do your job. Yeah. So a 10.8 there for India Team 2. Have you had any free time yet to enjoy Sydney?
Yeah. Tomorrow and day after tomorrow, I'll go to, you know, the harbour and
The Opera
Opera
House.
Yes. I would also like to go to the zoo, the kangaroo, the national.
You want to see a kangaroo? Yeah. What about a koala? Do you want to touch a koala?
that's a thing to be thought about. You know, I heard someone that that the koala is very dangerous. You know.
Oh, I don't know. I stroked one. So don't tell me that now. I stroked one.
Okay.
I stroked that bad boy. Yeah, I was caressing it. We were getting on quite fine, I'll have you know.
Yeah.
So don't be afraid. In fact, don't take my advice. don't take my advice. I think if you meet a wild one, maybe it's more dangerous, but in the actual zoo,
okay. They
have, I don't know how much I agree with this actually, but I guess they have the slightly sleepy ones, maybe sedated ones.
Yeah.
And you can have a photo with, and they're safe to touch and what have you. So,
yeah
maybe don't touch a wild koala. So, okay, so you want to see the Opera House, you want to see the bridge, you want to see a kangaroo.
Yeah.
That's pretty Australia, isn't it? That's ticking some serious Australian boxes. So that'll be tomorrow, and then are you going on to the Commonwealth Games?
No, I would like to watch it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some of the shooters are going. Even Manu Bhaka is going
amongst
these shooters.
Will they be? Of course, they're not going to go back to India. They're going to go direct to the Gold Coast.
They are going direct to the Gold Coast, yeah.
So you'll be
same
watching
country.
From back home?
Yeah, I'll be supporting them.
Of course. So they're 10.8 for China Team 2. And where are you from in India? Where do you live?
In India, I live in Punjab, Chandigarh.
So we've just had confirmation that Australia have had 1 point deducted from their total. So you mentioned that would have been for showing the trigger finger, perhaps, potentially.
Maybe.
It's always hard to tell, because obviously we're not privy to the discussions between the jury members and the athlete in question, but 1 point deduction confirmed for Australia. So that will not... It's not what I needed right now, is it?
Yes.
Currently in fifth place.
A 9.2 boy by Gaurav Rana. 9.2.
Yeah, but look at China Team 2. The most consistent in this series. 10.8, 10.2, 10.2. India Team 1. For them, that's a low
going
score.
Slowly.
Series.
10.2 by India 1.
And we've just had an 8.9 for Australia, so they really need to start getting some big scores on the board. Is it Anish you just saw?
Yeah.
Is he like the happiest man ever?
Yes,
he is. He's always smiling.
Yes, he's always smiling.
I mean, particularly when he wins a medal like yesterday.
Yes.
But
before a shot, he always smiled like, yeah, now I'll shoot a 10.9. That's the five hits. Yo, here you go.
And there's nothing wrong with either of these approaches, but you compare that to, we were talking about Barker, how focused and intense she looks, and then you see Anish he's just having it looks like he's having a laugh. Like thinking funny thoughts, but it works for both. Now it's a 10.8. So I suppose this is the moment now where you're starting to worry about the scores you're hitting and your position in the table, because single shots is where this is the business end of the final, isn't it?
Yes. India 2 has come down now to fourth place.
Yep, so I think there will be some change in this table by the end of the series. But India Team 1 picking up after a slow start, 10.8 followed by 10. Australia.
9.2 by Australia.
Yeah, they really need to start getting some bigger scores.
Yes.
Keep in contention. The closest rival, I think, stands is India Team 2. They have shot one more than China Team 2, so it just depends on what China hit. China. Okay, so that's the end of our five-shot series. This is how the table's looking. I mean, Australia, it's not looking good for them. There's our colleague Hanky enjoying a apple. good for her. That's one of our ISSF colleagues from the Munich office. But anyway, we've got a table here to look at, so Australia's not looking good for them because we're going into the single shots now. Two shots, individual shots, four per team to survive in this competition. India team one still leading away, and you know what? They've still got a pretty decent lead, haven't they? Over China team one now into joint second place with China team two, both tied on 293 each, and very tight between China one, China two, and India team two. What are they? They're just 0.2 behind.
India one has made a great lead.
They really have, and I was criticising them almost, wasn't I? Saying, oh, they're a bit slow in this series, aren't they? With hitting a few nines, but they're fine. They're fine.
You know, slow and steady wins the race.
Yeah, you're right. It's the baby steps he talks about, isn't it? More steps in Tokyo.
India comes to the third place now with the 10.1.
The crowd are enjoying this. And a 10.2 for China team two.
A 10.4 by Australia.
They need that, don't they? But it's followed by an
8.8.
Which is not what they needed. What was that, a 10? That was a 10.4 for Anmol, I think.
Yeah.
And there he is, the happiest man in the world.
Anish.
Little thumbs up to the camera, yeah. Anish. Yeah. Well, okay, we are now one shot away from the first elimination. I say one shot, it's two, really, per team. And it will be Australia team two exiting the competition. I think that's pretty safe to say. 301.6. So their closest rival, India team two, 312.5. Outright in second place is now China team two, previously tied with their Chinese teammates, team one. They're now 0.7 ahead and still leading the pack, India team one.
India one, yes. Making the lead bigger.
They are extending that lead, aren't they? They're not messing about.
They'll make a world record final junior also because it's the first event, you know?
Yep, so we're going to see history made once again, aren't we?
Once again, yeah. Australia teammate tensed.
Yeah. Yeah, they know. This is Hummer. 9.3. But, you know, all of these athletes, everyone's learning out there. You know, it's a new-ish event. Everyone's so young out there, you know, so there's no shame in taking fifth place, you know, in the final. No shame whatsoever. But there is confirmation, finishing with a total of 320.9. Australia taking fifth place in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team junior event here. So that's Hans, Ben, Homer, and Sasha Krupin.
And as you said earlier, now it's again India versus China.
Once again, yeah, we can rename again the final. Yeah, yeah, it's no longer the 10-meter air pistol mixed team. It's just India versus China.
Yeah.
And it is India winning. They're ahead of China team two, who are ahead of China team one, who are ahead of India team two. There's the table for you at home. So Australia have taken fifth place. There's one of the Chinese coaches. And there's one of the Chinese athletes. Of which there are four remaining in this competition. Just noticed that, I guess this was thought about in advance. So you see one of the China teams are wearing, China team two are wearing red, China team one are wearing blue.
Yeah.
And our Indian teams as well have sort of colour coordinated a bit as well.
Yeah.
Was that discussed, do you know?
No. Yeah, maybe that must be discussed, that the teams should be looking different. Mm. Like they are wearing the jackets and they're wearing the T-shirts.
It's like in football, a home and away kind of strip.
Yeah, right.
Oh, big cheers.
Looks beautiful.
It does look very nice. We imagine what would the big cheers for? Let's see. Probably a 10.3 maybe for India team two. Cheers. But there we go. We're getting very close to our next elimination. Currently in that danger zone is India team two, who are just 0.2 behind, just doing the maths on the fly here, 0.2 behind China team two. So that's going to be very interesting, isn't it? Now,
yeah.
Those two battling it out to remain in the competition for a medal. And of course, if we do have a tiebreak situation, there will be a shoot-off to settle that tie. So things could get very tense out there. Here we go again. And meanwhile, there's nothing tense about this for India Team 1 because they are flying out there in front.
Shoot-off for a medal is very difficult, you know. That has more that the pressure and the tense, you know.
Surely that's the pinnacle of the of pressure you'll ever experience in the
yes,
sport, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, so we've got a 10.5.
9.65 out of Rana.
Yeah, so this is about India Team 2. China Team 2 at the moment. As Agrawal, my friend from Guadalajara, she joined me in the commentary.
Yeah,
Guadalajara.
I heard that.
She was very good.
With the purple pistol.
Yeah, it's unique, I suppose. Okay, so fourth place has been decided, and as you can see on the screen right now, it is India Team 2. So they finish on a total of 370.2, just shy of China Team 2's 371. So that is Gaurav Rana and Mahima Turi Agrawal of India taking fourth place. And there's Miss Agrawal chatting to her coach. How do you think they'll be feeling right now taking fourth place? Like we said earlier with Australia, there's no shame in taking, you know, fifth or fourth in a final. But how,
yes.
I mean, but for an athlete, you're going to naturally be disappointed when you're not winning something, aren't you?
Yes, it is. You know, the first aim for a athlete is go up and up in the finals. But if you come out the fourth, yeah, it's very sad, you know, for a shooter. Like, you are just a few steps back from the medal.
So I suppose that's the coach's job, really, to say, look, you're going to be disappointed now, but tomorrow, you look back at this, fourth place, you should be proud.
Yes. In the starting, it feels like it's very bad, but you know, the fourth place, it's very awesome. It's not bad.
It's not bad at all.
Yes.
Fourth place, a World Cup. But the final goes on. India Team 1, China Team 1, China Team 2, which had a big cheer.
A 10.6 by Anmol Rana.
And we had a 10.7 in there for China Team 1. So, starting at the top, it is still India Team 1 with Anmol and Barker leading the pack. Then it's Liu and Li of China Team 1. And it's Wang and Zhao of China Team 3. So this is the bronze medal now. This shot is for the bronze. Currently, it's China Team 2 on 390.1 looking to make up 1.6 on China Team 1. So a bit of work to do there.
Yeah.
But we say it's a single shot. It's two shots, in fact. So if you both shoot well, you never know.
The China shooter with that aggression. With the 10.6.
Yeah. That's China 2. Currently in the bronze spot. At a 10, so it will be bronze to China Team 2. He's in a good position, isn't he? I guess all the coaches are. They know they're getting medals now for their teams.
Yeah, right.
So there we have it. China Team 2, the People's Republic of China Team 2. Wang Jihao and Zhao Xiao Jiawisha taking the bronze medal in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team event here at the ISSF Junior World Cup. So yeah, finishing with a total of 410.7, signing out with a 10.6 and a 10 individually. Wasn't quite enough to catch their compatriots, China Team 1, who are in second place, 412.9. Look at the gap there between China 1 and India 1.
That's great.
But
the lead is increasing.
It is. It's just gradually creased throughout this final. They've just not budged. However, we now have three shots to decide a gold medal. So there are six shots per team still out there.
But
it's not over yet.
But I'm sure India 1 will not stop. They will try to increase their lead as much as possible.
Well, the way they've been going, I think you're right.
Yeah. A 10.7 by Manu Bhaka.
Yeah, they're not ready to give up their lead, are they? They've got a 10.4 for China. Not bad, but they need to be beating India's scores. Shot for shot. So here's Anmol.
A 10.7 from China 1 as well.
Ooh, a 9.7 for Amol. So a 10.4 and a 10.7 for China, a 10.7 and a 9.7. So that lead has gone down.
Yeah.
You've cursed them, I think. The commentator's curse.
Yes.
So it's a 5. It's a 5-point lead now. With two shots individually, 4 per team remaining. Are you still feeling confident for your teammates?
Yeah. The lead is very much. I don't think that China will try to make that.
I think you might be right, but you never know. No. Stranger things have happened in this sport.
Yeah.
So here we go again. You're looking at Anmol and Barker, the leaders.
A 9.4 by China.
That's not the kind of score they need right now.
And a 9.3 from Manu Barker as well.
Yep. There's a... Support your coaches supporting.
Yeah. A 10.1 from China. That long hold. A 10.0.
Okay, well, I think that pretty much settles it, doesn't it? But it is not over yet. It's not over yet. There's a happy team from India.
Yeah.
Cheering on their team one, who are number one, 459.2 to China team one's 453.5. It does come down to this final shot. That's two shots now per team remaining in the final. And Mr. Jaspal, I think you were right to be confident, but still, it's not over yet.
We know it. Never know.
The crowd are getting into this one now. Clapping along. Slow clap, fast clap, I call it.
I think that's the reason, the reason of that, you know, the lead, the 5 points lead. That's the reason, the support,
the support
from the
Indian
team.
That's inspired the Indian team out there.
Yes.
This is Anmol.
A 10.5 from China. A 10.5 as well.
Well, there we go. That settles that one then. Signing out with 10.5. So,
we have our gold medalist.
Yeah, and it's going to your teammates, my friend. So, India team one. Anmol, you can see there. And Manu Barker accepting the cheers, big cheers from their teammates, from the audience here in Sydney. Finishing on a total of 478.9. China team one, though, they battled hard. And they finished with a total of 473.3. So China team one taking the silver medal. That's Liu Jinyao and Li Xu of the People's Republic of China. We now have our medal winners lining up. And they'll accept one more big cheer from the audience, from a young audience member there we just saw on screen. So, yeah, bronze medal to the People's Republic of China team two that you can see there. The silver medal to the People's Republic of China team one in the blue. And then, of course, as we just discussed, the gold medal going to India team one. So Jepchesh Singh Jaspal, my guest. What would you say about that final? How would you summarize it in just a couple of sentences?
the lead, you know, that was the main thing in the finals. You looked at support by Indian teammates. Yeah,
amazing support. Yeah.
Yeah.
And that helped them.
Yeah, that was the reason, I guess. The claps, the cheering, you know, the whistles.
Yeah, inspirational.
Yes.
So, you mentioned you're going home after 2 days of sightseeing in Sydney.
Yeah.
What's next for you in terms of shooting sport? What competitions have you got next?
I have some local competitions, and then the selection will be for the World Cup Seoul, Junior World Cup Seoul. There, I will try for that, from winning that, and look forward to meet you again over there.
Yeah, hopefully I'll see you in Seoul then, my friend. That would be great to see you there in Germany for the next Junior World Cup. Well, I wish you all the best with that, with qualifying and with your local competitions. as well. And there for you at home is just a reminder of the results from the 10 meter air pistol mixed team junior event. We'll be back with the rifle equivalent shortly, so join us once again. And if you want to relive this final in all of its glory, we'll be putting it on the ISSF YouTube channel shortly. So that'll be there sometime in the evening, local time, if not tomorrow morning at the latest. It's all internet connection depending. But we are on Instagram and Facebook, so there'll be very professional, beautiful photographs from this final on those social media platforms, as well as the ISSF website. So once again, to my guest, Jepchesh Singh Jaspal, I hope I got your name right throughout
yes,
the final.
Yes, that was perfect.
When I wasn't feeling so confident, I just went with Mr. Jaspal. You probably noticed that. But thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you again in Seoul.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you. And thank you at home, and we'll see you again shortly. We've got two more finals coming up today on day 6.